The Constitution of India, Preamble. We, the people of India, having solemnly resolved to constitute India into a sovereign, socialist, secular, democratic republic and to secure to all its citizens justice, social, economic and political, liberty of thought, expression, belief, faith and worship, equality of status and of opportunity, and to promote among them all fraternity, assuring the dignity of the individual and the unity and integrity of the nation. In our Constituent Assembly, this 26th day of November 1949, do hereby adopt, enact and give to ourselves this Constitution.
Hi all, hope all is well. Today I'm gonna deal with the second chapter from the first unit, The Glimpses of Green. Before moving on to the chapter, let me ask you, do you like to look at the mirror? Of course, yes. Yes, children, because who don't like to look smart and beautiful always, right? So before introducing the lesson, let me show you an image. Have you ever seen an animal looking into the mirror or looking at the mirror? What idea did you get from this image? What did you see in the image? You saw a snake looking at the mirror. So today we are gonna deal with the lesson, The Snake and the Mirror by V.M. Bashir or Vaikom Muhammad Bashir. Okay, The Snake and the Mirror. By V.M. Bashir or Vaikom Muhammad Bashir. Vaikom Muhammad Bashir was born in the year 1908 and he passed away in the year 1994. He is well known as Bepur Sultan. Okay, he is known as the activist, freedom fighter, humanist. His famous works are Balyakala Sakhi, Madilugal and Anarga Nimishangal. He got Padma Shri in the year 1982. His writings were down to earth and because of that he got lot of criticism for his works. As a humanist, he used to give lot of importance or lot of concern for the survival or for the existence of all living creatures, including the nature in his work. He says that all the living creatures has equal right to live and survive in this universe. So we humans are not supposed to harm those animals or those creatures. Instead, we have to live in harmony with the nature. Now let us watch a small video. What did you see in the video? You saw beautiful valleys and rivers, mountains, as well as plants and trees, animals, birds, etc. So God has created such a beautiful universe for us. So we have to live in harmony with the nature. V.M. Bashir, in one of his works, Bhoomide Avagashigal, has described very beautifully the love and concern towards the nature as well as all the living creatures. All of us has the equal right to live and survive, and we have to blend with the nature instead of harming the other creatures, right? The love towards the nature as well as the creatures is one of his doctrines. Okay, and now in this lesson, The Snake and the Mirror, we are gonna know about the protagonist of the lesson, a homeopath. Who is an homeopath? Of course, it's a homeopathy doctor. So he is living in a rented room and he is sharing the room with rats. Okay, what do you do if you see rat in your house? Will you allow them to live with you in the house? Never, right? So here the homeopath, one day due to this rats, a snake came there and it coiled on the homeopath's body. But instead of harming the snake, he ran away from the house and he allowed the snake to be there in his room. Right? So what did you understand from this? The blend towards the nature and the harmony to live with the nature. This is the main doctrine in all of V.M. Bashir's work.
Sukhdev Thapar, Shivram Rajguru, who were executed while he was in Kannur. He resolved to join the fight for Indian independence, leaving school while he was in the fifth form. He was known for his secular attitude. He was awarded Padma Shri in 1982, and he was fondly remembered as the Bepur Sultan.
Let's read the lesson now. The Snake and the Mirror. Has a snake ever coiled itself round any part of your body? A full-blooded cobra? All of us fell silent. The question came from the homeopath. The topic came up when we were discussing snakes. We listened attentively as the doctor continued with the tale. It was a hot summer night, about 10 o'clock. I had my meal at the restaurant and returned to my room. I heard a noise from above as I opened the door. The sound was a familiar one. One could say that rats and I shared the room. I took out my box of matches and lighted the kerosene lamp on the table. The house was not electrified. It was a small rented room. I had just set up medical practice and my earnings were meager. I had about 60 rupees in my suitcase. Along with some shirts and dhotis, I also possessed one solitary black coat which I was then wearing. So from the three paragraphs, you would have understood that the homeopath is having a chit chat with his friends. And in between the discussion, they talked about, or they had a discussion about the snakes. Okay, and the homeopath is asking to his friends, has a snake ever coiled itself around any part of your body? A full-blooded cobra. What does it mean by full-blooded cobra? Full-blooded cobra means a strong and healthy snake. Okay, full-blooded means strong and healthy. So has a full-blooded cobra has ever coiled in your body? And he's also explaining that it was a hot summer night, about 10 o'clock, and his room was not electrified. He used to hear the sound of rats every day from the roof. Okay, and he is also saying that he had just set up medical practice and his earnings were meager. Meager means very less. He had about 60 rupees in his suitcase. along with some shirts and dhotis. He also possessed one solitary, solitary means single, one solitary black coat which he was then wearing. He was wearing that black coat and he was sitting there. So he heard the sound. As usual, he used to hear that sound every day, and today also he heard the sound of rats on the roof. Now let's see the fourth para. I took off my black coat, white shirt and not so white vest and hung them up. I opened the two windows in the room. It was an outer room with one wall facing the open yard. It had a tiled roof with long supporting gables that rested on the beam over the wall. There was no ceiling. There was a regular traffic of rats to and from the beam. I made my bed and pulled it close to the wall. I lay down, but I could not sleep. I got up and went out to the veranda for a little air, but the wind god seemed to have taken time off. So what did he do? He just removed his coat, his vest and hung them up in the clothesline. He opened the two windows in the room. It was an outer room with one wall facing the open yard. It had a tiled roof with long supporting gables. Now what is gable? You can see in the picture. You can see the rats in the gable. Okay, so long supporting gables that rested on the beam over the wall. There was no ceiling. There was a regular traffic of rats to and from the beam. So the rats daily used to move to and from the beam, means here and there through the beam. I made my bed and pulled it close to the wall. I lay down, but I could not sleep. I got up and went out to the veranda for a little air, but the wind god seemed to have taken time off. Means it was too hot and he was not getting sleep due to this hot. And so he just moved out to the veranda, but there also the wind god seemed to have taken time off. Means the wind god didn't bless him, so there was no wind outside also in the veranda. Right? I hope you got up to this. Now let's discuss the question answer. So what is the first question? What was the topic that came up for discussion between the doctor and his friends? The topic was about the snakes. What does the expression "a full-blooded cobra" suggest? Full-blooded cobra means a healthy and strong cobra. The sound was a familiar one. What was the sound? The sound was of the rats. Okay, now let's read the next three paras. I went back into the room and sat down on the chair. I opened the box beneath the table and took out a book, the Materia Medica. I opened it at the table on which stood the lamp and a large mirror. A small comb lay beside the mirror. One feels tempted to look into a mirror when it is near. I took a look. In those days, I was a great admirer of beauty and I believed in making myself look handsome. I was unmarried and was a doctor. I felt I had to make my presence felt. I picked up the comb and ran it through my hair and adjusted the parting so that it looked straight and neat. Again, I heard that sound from above. I took a close look at my face in the mirror. I made an important decision. I would shave daily and grow a thin mustache to look more handsome. I was, after all, a bachelor and a doctor. I looked into the mirror and smiled. It was an attractive smile. I made another earth-shaking decision. I would always keep that attractive smile on my face to look more handsome. I was, after all, a bachelor and a doctor too, on top of it. Again came that noise from above. So, as there was no wind outside in the veranda also, he came inside. He sat on a chair and he opened the book Materia Medica. Materia Medica is a book, medical book, which he just opened. And near to this book, there was a mirror as well as a lamp. Also, a comb was kept there. So, it is always a tendency when we see the mirror to look into the mirror. So, the doctor here, he too had such a tendency and he looked at the mirror. He was thinking at that time, in those days, I was a great admirer of beauty and I believed in making myself look handsome. He always tried to keep him or make his looks beautiful. Okay, he always tried to keep him handsome. I was unmarried and was a doctor. He was unmarried as well as he's having a good profession as a doctor. I felt I had to make my presence felt. He felt that he should always make his presence felt to others. So when we see some beautiful girls or handsome boys, it's all will have a tendency to look at them. Okay, a thing of beauty is always joy forever. You might have heard that proverb, right, children? So always beautiful things gives us happiness. So it's a tendency to look at the mirror also and make us keep us always smart and beautiful. Here the doctor is also having the same tendency. He was thinking that he was unmarried and was a doctor. I felt I had to make my presence felt. I picked up the comb and ran it through my hair and adjusted the parting so that it looked straight and neat. He took the comb and he parted his hair and he combed it straight and neat. Again, I heard that sound from above. I took a close look at my face in the mirror. I made an important decision. After he was hearing the sound, but he didn't care for it. And he just made a close look to the mirror. And I would shave daily and grow a thin mustache to look more handsome. He took an important decision that he would shave daily and grow thin mustache to look more handsome. I was, after all, a bachelor and a doctor. I looked into the mirror and smiled. It was an attractive smile. I made another earth-shaking decision. Again, after combing his hair, again smiling, everything, he just looked once again to the mirror and he took another earth-shaking decision. What was that? I would always keep that attractive smile on my face. He decided to keep that attractive smile on his face every day, every time. To look more handsome, so that he will look more handsome. I was, after all, a bachelor and a doctor too on top of it. So he is again saying that he is a bachelor as well as, who is said to be a bachelor? Bachelor means unmarried men are said to be bachelors. So he was, after all, a bachelor and a doctor too on top of it. Again came that noise from above. So that's it. Now let's discuss the question answers from fourth question onwards. In those days, I was a great admirer of beauty. Pick out phrases and expressions from the story to justify the statement. So in the sixth para, you can see that in those days, I was a great admirer of beauty and I believed in making myself look handsome. I was unmarried and was a doctor. I felt I had to make my presence felt. I picked up the comb and ran it through my hair and adjusted the parting so that it looked straight and neat. So till that you have to write by changing the pronouns in the sentences. That is the expression or the phrase which is given there. That he makes us understand that he was the admirer of beauty. The next one, what are the two important and earth-shaking decisions that the doctor takes while looking into the mirror? The first important decision is that he would shave daily and grow a thin mustache to look more handsome. And the earth-shaking decision is that he would always keep that attractive smile on his face. Now next question, again came that noise from above. Did the doctor pay much attention to the noise? Why? No, the doctor did not pay much attention to the noise because he used to hear the noise daily. So he did not give much attention to the noise. Okay, so till that, it's over. And today's assignment. So I hope you got an idea about V.M. Bashir or Vaikom Muhammad Bashir and about his writing style. Also, you got half idea about the lesson also. The protagonist of the story is homeopath. And what are the important or earth-shaking decisions that he took in today's class? Right, children? So I'm going to stop this session here. And see you in the next class. Bye.